Hey everybody, Ivan from Weights and Biases here. In this video, I'd like to show you how you can train YOLOv5 on Google CallUp using a small dataset and then track and visualize your experiments using Weights and Biases dashboard. So, since we're gonna be using Google CallUp for training, that means that you can follow along by just clicking the link in the description and opening the CallUp notebook. First, let's clone and set up YOLOv5 repo by clicking on the first cell. This will git clone the YOLOv5 repository from GitHub into CallUp, as well as install all the required modules along the way. Once the setup is complete, you should be able to see all the YOLOv folders and files in the CallUp file view. Now, to make sure that we actually have, you know, the working and functioning neural network here, let's run the inference on one of the example images from the repo. Looking good so far. Now, the example dataset that we're gonna be using is Coco128, which is essentially a really small dataset with just 128 first images from the original Coco dataset. This will allow us to see how the training visualizations work without having to wait for too long, you know, for the model to train. Let's click this cell to download the Coco128 dataset. We can now see it appear in the CallUp files view. Let's check out a few images from there. Now, let's move on to the exciting part, which is training. First, since weights and biases are a part of YOLOv5, all we have to do is to just pip install WNB by clicking the cell to be able to then track our experiments. So the next cell will start the training. Here we can specify the input resolution of our images, number of epochs, the batch size, as well as the dataset that we're using. And last but not least, we also specify the pre-trained YOLOv5 weights to take advantage of transfer learning. After seeing the logs of the successfully loaded model, we can sign into our weights and biases accounts to visualize the results. If you don't have an account, you can take a few moments to create one. And since I, you know, already have an account, I'll just, you know, authenticate into the weights and biases dashboard. Now the training has started. If it's your first YOLOv5 run, Weights and Biases will automatically create a private project in your account where you can find your dashboard. Click on the View Project link to open it and see the data about how your model is doing that's being automatically pulled in real time. When you open the project, right at the top, you'll see one of my favorite features around here, which is the bounding box debugger. Let's enlarge the window and take a closer look at it. The bounding box debugger plots random images from the val dataset with the bounding boxes and the confidence scores, giving you the intuition for what's going on in the model during training beyond just, you know, the raw numbers and the training logs. You can see how the model performed in the images at each step of the training, choose the confidence threshold of the plotted bounding boxes, or to display or not display certain classes from your dataset. If you scroll a bit lower, you'll see a lot of useful metrics, including the average precision, GPU usage, training and validation losses. Those are being updated in real time as your model trains. Now, let's do something interesting. We're going to train a model for a second time, but with different hyperparameters. Just for example, I'll change the input resolution from 640 to 416, batch size from 30 to 64, and epochs from 10 to 35. And let's start our training. Now, taking a look at the dashboard again, you'll see a new run appear in the runs panel on the left. And now, look at this. we can actually compare the performance of different runs with different configurations side to side. With several runs selected, the bounding box debugger now lets us see how each of the models does on each of the images selected there. We can specify which images we wanted to look at a time, as well as at what training step, and what are going to be the confidence thresholds and the classes that we wanted to display. This is a great way to get some intuitive understanding for how different configurations of your models actually work. The training charts now let us see the numbers for each model nicely plotted next to each other. And the GPU usage metrics can give you some invaluable insights as to how each of the models utilizes the GPU, so you can pick the right hardware for the training. But there's more. If we click on the run and then click on the magical overview button for the run, we'll find all the hyperparameters used for training our model. This applies to all of the runs that we'll have, and this way you can keep track of the different configurations of different models while doing your experiments and seeing how they perform. You can also see the charts for each of the runs, all the different system metrics, the logs during training, and like it also got the logs, you know, as well as a few other useful files stored there. So using weights and biases to track your YOLOv5 runs and train models gives you some really awesome insights and intuitions for how the training is going while letting you effectively keep track of all of your experiments. You can try it out yourself on Google CallUp. You can find the link to the notebook in the description. Feel free to train some models and track some awesome experiments. We hope you enjoy it.